The release of the orange juice crop in the movie Trading Places is both funny and accurate. It's a real classic. What you got to do is, if you've already seen the movie, you should take a look at it again. Fast forward to the pit activity, both before and after the crop report was released. Florida is another movie. This one you could see for free on YouTube. It's an excellent documentary film on pit trading. You'd also read the story about Daryl Zimmerman, who on October 22nd, 1992, tried to corner the Treasury bond futures market. You could Google this up. It's a fine article that was written in the Chicago Reader. Daryl Zimmerman failed in his attempt at cornering the market and spent a good 4 years in jail. That's not the right way to trade. Innovator's Dilemma was published in 2002. It discusses it's a very good discussion on the effects of disruptive technologies. In another book, Fortune's Formula, was published in 2005. It reveals the role that math played in the evolution of trading. Futures trading began in Chicago in 1848. But even though the Board of Trade building is located at LaSalle and Jackson, I never bothered to learn anything about what took place there. I had absolutely no interest in being a farmer. It wasn't until after I graduated college that I even heard of anyone talking about the Board of Trade. After graduation, I struggled to find a profession that would appeal to me. When I was 30 years old, I accidentally discovered the world of trading. I remember visiting the Chicago Options Exchange, and I looked around at all the chaos that was going down there. I immediately recognized that this was just a game. But it was a very competitive and a very physical game. I also saw that in order to play this game, you had to be very adept at simple arithmetic. In life, great things often happen by chance. Fate somehow placed me at the right place, and the right place was Chicago. And 1975 was the right time. It was the beginning of financial futures. And third, and most important, is that I knew I was at the right place at the right time. Back then, very few people saw what I saw. The Board of Trade tried to sell 100 six-month Ginnie Mae permits to trade mortgage futures. But even after extensive promotion, they were only able to sell 19. So I started trading with $3,000 in capital. On my second day of trading, so I was too afraid to trade on the first day, but I lost $100. And I did some quick calculations, and I figured if I kept doing this for another 30 days, I'd be totally broke. However, somehow I was able to persevere. I had a number of ups and downs, but I'm happy to say that I've put a great deal of distance between myself and zero. Trading volume back then, as you've heard from other speakers, it was pretty microscopic compared to what we see today. There were certainly opportunities. Back then, there were a lot more volatility, but you could argue that opportunities today are even greater. Competition, however, is brutal. So in order to play, it's essential to have major math or computer skills in addition to having excellent instincts. Trading is not a secure profession. Regulations can change, competition can disrupt, and skills diminish. It's important to live modestly and to make sure that you accumulate savings so that you can ride out any unforeseen disruptions. I've seen numerous traders and even large trading firms disappear overnight because they underestimated consequences. Don Wilson had a front row seat in Lehman Brothers liquidation in 2008, and it was he's one that very much kept his risk parameters very much intact, so he was able to participate in that to a great advantage for himself. It took him from one level to a gigantic level. Striving to know what I don't know keeps me involved. I never want to risk what I've accomplished. You know, in 1975, circumstances required me to risk everything I had. Today, that's not the case. But the older I get, the more cautious I get. And trust me, this will happen to you when you reach my age. My most important legacy, however, is my name and my reputation that I have in the market, and that's not available at any price. So there's a certain thing at this day in terms of ethics that I never want to get caught in a situation where someone's questioning what I'm, you know, the moral or ethics or legality of what I'm doing. For many years, trading was, when it was in the pits, it was sort of like every man for themselves. If you knew something, you certainly didn't share it. It was something, if you had a good idea, you kept it to yourself. It was individual against individual, or maybe individual against the market. There's still an element of that today in today's markets. There's there's a good number of very talented individuals that somehow can sort of sense the direction of the market and consistently make profitable trades. But today, there's a strong trend away from individual competition, especially in market making, in the electronic era that we're in now, it's going more toward a team-oriented approach. Similar to what Don Wilson was talking about, at TMG, our successful computer-driven trading strategies require contributions from software developers, network engineers, database consultants, coders, as well as experienced traders. We also have incentives in place to encourage and promote the exchange of ideas between various trading units. For instance, we may have a good strategy that works in energy, and we try and communicate that, so maybe we can sort of tweak it a little bit and have that same strategy work for interest rates or for metals or for ags. So it's really important that my firm is very diversified, and just like Don's, I'm a sort of a smaller version of what Don Wilson's firm is, but nevertheless, we still have an impact. We still have a presence at CME and do substantial volume. My goal one day is to be like Don. At any rate, being diversified really helps, and having a cooperative sharing of ideas is something that's really important. Technology breakthroughs in our industry are continuing to evolve. New trading tools are being constantly introduced. In some cases, like at Transmarket, we develop and make our own tools, but there's still a large number of tools that are available on publicly available software, so you don't have to depend on proprietary trading tools to make your way in this business. Tools enable folks like you to analyze markets better. It's almost a certainty that some of you are going to be working on algorithmic projects that'll obsolete some of the money-generating models that are being utilized today. There are many new breakthroughs that are yet to be discovered, both in present-day contracts as well as in contracts that are yet to be listed, and maybe on exchanges that are yet to be formed. The record of success that is embodied by the speakers today are going to be eclipsed by some of you. So I expect some of you, Dan, someone in this room is probably going to do better than you. That's a for sure thing. That's a certainty. There's a lot more work to be done. So in conclusion, I want to quote from the most interesting man in the world over a bottle of Dos Equis. All I have to say is, stay thirsty, my friends.